Vasudevaya.
Om namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. So we're reading the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 12, devotional service, text number 15.
今天我们要学习的是国家梵歌第十二章的第十五节诗，标题是奉爱服务第十二章。
Yasmin Nadvijate Loko
Yasmin Nadvijate Loko
Lokan Nadvijate Chaya
Lokan Nadvijate Chaya
Asha Masha Bayo Vege
Asha Masha Bayo Vege
Mutoya Sa Sanitriya
Mutoya Sa Sanitriya
Yasman Yodvijate Loko
Yasman Yodvijate Loko
Lokana Dvijate Chaya
Lokana Dvijate Chaya
Harsha Masha Bayoke
Harsha Masha Bayoke
Muktoya Sachanetriya
Muktoya Sachanetriya
Yasman Nadvijate Loko
Yasman Nadvijate Loko
Lokan Nadvijate Chaya
Lokan Nadvijate Chaya
Asha Masha Bayodvege
Asha Masha Bayodvege
Muktoya Sachanetriya Okay, you chant.
Yashman no jijate lokal, lokan no jijate chaya, harsha marsha bayo regai, mokto yas satra me kuya.
Very good.
现在来看一下这个。
这段字，从他。
Never,
永不。
Uchujatay,
被打扰。
Agitating,
被打扰。
Loka,
他。 人。
Loka, from people.
Loka, 从人。
Na,
永不。
Agitating, is disturbed.
不安。
Ja, also.
还有。
Yeah, anyone.
任何人。
Asha, from happiness.
由快乐。
Amasha, distress.
痛苦。
Baya, fear.
Baya, 恐惧。
不追根。 And anxiety.
和焦虑。
Moksha, free.
Mokshaha, 摆脱了。
Ya, who?
Ya, 谁？
Sha, anyone.
Sha, 任何人。
Cha, also.
Cha, 还有。
Meaning to me.
对我。
Ria, very dear.
很亲切。
Translation. You want to just read the Chinese? Go ahead.
Okay. 我们现在, 直接来聆听一下这些诗的译文。 卢舍人的A.C. 巴克利的丹丹斯方面 Prabhupada所做的译文， 我极喜爱的奉献者， 不把他人置于困境， 不被任何人所打扰， 在令人快乐痛苦， 恐惧和焦虑的情况下， 始终平静。 Maharaj also proposed?
Yes.
要旨。 这里进一步描述了奉献者的一些品质，这样的一位奉献者不会把任何生物体置于困难、焦虑、恐惧和不满中。由于奉献者善待众生，他不做让其他生物体感到焦虑的事，同时， 如果其他人试图让奉献者焦虑，奉献者是不会受打扰的。这尊主的恩典使他变得如此有经验，以致不受外界的干扰。事实上，因为奉献者一直全神贯注于 Krishna 知觉意识，做奉爱服务，所以这种物质情况 根本就影响不了他。物质主义者通常在拥有某些可供自己满足感官和躯体的事物时，就变得十分快乐。在看到他人有可供他们进行感官享乐的事物，而自己没有时，就会感到难过和嫉妒。 在认为他的一个仇敌要报复时，就感到恐惧；在做不成某些事情时，就变得沮丧。Krishna 非常喜爱始终超越这一切干扰的奉献者。译文：我极喜爱的奉献者，不把他人置于困境。 不被任何人所打扰，在令人快乐、痛苦、恐惧和焦虑的情况下，始终平静。Yes,
Maharaj. Shri Gurave Namaha. Shri Chaitanya Manodisham Stapitam Yena Bhuttave Svayam Rupa Tadamayam Tadati Svapadantikam. Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata Pada Kamalam Shri Gurum Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sakrajatam Tahadana Radhanatantitam Tamsatevam Sadvaitam Sarvadutam Parijana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Ravita Shri Krishna Kadipamscha He Krishna Karana Sindhu Dina Bandhu Chajatpade Gopesha Gopita Kanta Radha Kanta Namastate Tapta Kanchana Korange Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanusute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kaupana Dunyasya Kripa Sindhu Vaya Vacha Adita Nam Pavani Vyo Kashmari Vyo Namo Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Krishnaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namane Namaste Saraswati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srimasati Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. So we're reading chapter 12 of the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describing devotional service. And here, he has mentioned the qualifications of a devotee.
Mm. 我们今天进行到《活着梵歌》第十二章，讲述的是奉爱服务。那今天的诗节主要的是在讲述Krishna 他的纯粹的奉献者所具有的优良品质。
So we can understand from the verse today, we understand that it's not a very easy thing to be a devotee. You have to be very controlled. You have to have a lot of control over your mind and senses.
我们今天读到今天的这一个诗节，我们就可以感受到，其实要成为一个真正的奉献者，绝非易事啊，因为奉献者需要做很多内在的功夫，必须要学习怎么样真正的去控制好自己的心意，才能够符合到这今天这几诗所谈到的这种水平。
So we learn that a real devotee doesn't get disturbed when things go wrong in their life.
我们在这节诗中学习到一个真正的奉献者，他在遭受就是一些外在的状况发生的时候，他不会受到外在的状况的打扰。
He's not afraid of any material situation.
He is not afraid.
Yeah,
他不恐惧任何物质的处境。
And he remains satisfied in his activities.
他全然的就是稳处在就是内在的这种状态中感到心满意足。
So, of course, these qualifications are quite difficult for us because we're conditioned souls and we're not accustomed to behave like this.
那么毫无疑问的，这样的境界对我们来说是非常困难的，因为我们现在的状况都是受制约的状态，所以我们还非常的受到外在的这种东西的，对外在的东西有很多的依附执着。
That's because we are conditioned to material life, we have many desires.
我们受制于物质的生存中。
These desires bring us trouble.
对，我们现在受制于我们物质的生存。我们还有那么多的物质欲望，就是因为这些欲望，让我们惹上那么多的麻烦。
And the more we have desires, the more we get anxiety when our desires are not fulfilled.
我们的欲望越多越强烈，我们的焦虑也就越深。
How to overcome these problems? How can we remain satisfied and not be fearful?
那我们如何去超越这些呢？我们如何能够始终在内在感受到满足，而不去为外在的状况而感受到焦虑恐惧呢？
Often people will go to the drugstore.And they will get some medicine for their anxiety. They will take some kind of pill and some kind of tablet to stop them feeling anxiety, to stop their depression.
现在的人们真的因为这种状况而处在一种非常的焦虑，甚至是非常的忧郁的状态。那么人们可能会去药局买一些药，一些药锭、药丸。想办法来解除自己的这种心中的挥之不去的这种焦虑、忧郁。
Yeah. Nowadays, it's very common for young people that it's so much anxiety that they have to go to psychiatrists, and the psychiatrist will prescribe some drug for them.Control their mind for them.
现在其实有很多的年轻人，他们就遭受到这种状况，他们的心其实处在非常混乱的状态，非常的焦虑恐惧。那么他们甚至于要去诉诸于找心理咨商，那么这些心理咨商师就会给他们开一些药物给他们吃，帮助他们来控制自己的心。
However, there's another process by which they can control their mind and senses. They will be willing to take up devotional steps.
然而，人们刚才讲的是一种方法，可是我们还有另外一种方法，可以帮助人们去解决这个问题，这种心理的问题，那就是我们来学习做奉爱服务。以奉爱服务的程序来解救这种内心的问题。
We have to be willing to hear transcendental knowledge.
我们必须
very carefully.
我们必须非常仔细的来聆听这些超然的知识。
Of course, we also have to have faith in what we're hearing.We have to accept it as true.
那么我们可能就是还没有具足足够的这种信心，我们必须真正的要去培养这样的信心，来对于这个事实能够真正的来接受。
Just like when the spiritual teacher tells us to chant the Maha Mantra.We have to chant. We have to do what he says. We have to follow the instruction.
我们必须要学习去聆听
指导我们的灵性老师们的灵性导师们的教导，比方说他教我们要好好的念诵 Hare Krishna Maha Mantra， 我们应该好好的这么做。
And if we chant in the proper manner, following the rules and regulations, then the chanting will definitely help us to get free of all anxiety.
如果我们真的按照老师的这种教导，以一种正确的方式、正确的心态来吟诵、吟唱 Hare Krishna， 而且我们还很好的遵循这些规范的原则，那么肯定我们内在的这种焦虑、忧郁肯定会一扫而空，烟消云散。
By nature, we are all devotees. Krishna consciousness is in all of us.
其实我们每一个生命在本质上都是天生的奉献者。所以我们原本都具有 Krishna 知觉意识。
If we have the faith to listen carefully to the knowledge of the Bhagavad Gita and the teachings of Lord Krishna and to apply the teachings regularly, then certainly we will get the result.
所以我们要所要做的，我们就是要怀着信心来聆听这些知识，来聆听 Krishna 的教导比方说像薄伽梵歌Krishna 所教导我们的这一切，并且我们能够恒常的把所学习的这些知识运用在我们的生活中，我们肯定就能够走出这种物质的这种困境。物质的焦虑
，all the anxiety and the fear and the difficulties which we have, they're all due to us identifying with the material body, and they're causing us so many troubles.
其实我们所有的一切的焦虑、恐惧，还有我们现在所处的困难。其实真正的原因是因为我们认同了错误的东西，我们认同自己就是这个躯体，认同了所有物质的东西，所以我们才会深陷于这样的困境。
Often we feel envy of another person. When we see someone else is successful, we will envy them.
有些时候我们看到身边的人其他的人，他们的生活怎么能够过得这么成功？我们心里就不由自主的嫉妒起来。
Just like someone may marry the beautiful girl, someone gets a very attractive girl, and we think, oh, why he gets such a beautiful girl for a wife? Why I can't get that girl for a wife? Huh?
You say beautiful what?
A beautiful woman.
Oh, beautiful woman. 所以有时候我们看到别人，我们见不得别人好看到有的人，你看他享有那么多的好东西你看他有身边就看到美丽的女人、美女。
Or someone gets a job with a very high salary.And so many benefits. They get a house and a car, and oh, they got such a big salary. We may envy them.
有时候看到别人的工作怎么那么好，位居高职高位，然后赚那么多钱，怎么可以有这样的名车豪宅？我们立刻就心里变得很不平衡，很受不了。
So that's the nature of the material world. People in the consciousness of the body, they will envy another person. They will envy their success.
其实这就是物质存在的本质在物质存在中，人们是那么的嫉妒， 啊，那因此看到别人拥有比自己多比自己好的东西啊，他们就是没有办法去就是就不开心了，就嫉妒了因为是那么的认同这个外在的东西，所以才会被这样的东西所捆绑。
Srila Prabhupada told a story about how there were two men, and the one man was boasting about his son. He said, "My son has become the high court judge."
Srila Prabhupada 就讲了一个故事，他说有一个人呢，他就很得意的就说，我的孩子啊，他成为了一个高等法官，他就很得意的告诉别人这件事情。
So the other man who was listening to him was, he was jealous, and he didn't want to recognize the success of the other man's son.
那另外一个人听到这个人呢，好，就是很自豪的在称赞自己的儿子成为高等法官，他就很受不了，他就很嫉妒啊，他就不想承认这个事实。
And the result was, the other man said, "Well, he may be a high court judge, but he's not. I don't think he can be getting the salary of the high court judge."
The man think he cannot get a high salary.
The man said, the one man said to the other man, the one man saying his son is a high court judge.So the other man said, "Well, your son may be a high court judge, but I don't think he gets the pay of a high court judge."
对，那另外一个嫉妒的人，他就听到这样的说，他说：“也许你的孩子成为了高等法院的法官，可是我不认为他可以得到这个所谓的高等这个法官的这么高的职位的薪水，我是认为他不会得到这么高的薪水。”
So that is the nature of envy. That's how people would be envious of another person.
所以这个就是物质存在的这种本质，人是那么的充满了嫉妒。
We don't like to recognize another person's success.
我们不想去真的去承认接受别人的成功。
We like to think about our own self, that we want to see that we are successful. I should be successful.
我们想要就是认为自己才是真正成功的，我应该才是那个成功的人，我才是成功的，把焦点都放在自己的身上。
And when we see other people suffering, then we feel happy.
而看到别人痛苦的时候，我们心里面还有一点高兴。
And when we see them successful, then we're envious.
看到别人成功的时候，却那么的心怀嫉妒。
That's the nature of material world.
这就是物质存在的本质。
People in the material world don't think like this.
物质存在，人们就是这么想的，他的心，人们的心态就是如此。
They only think about their own self. They're very selfish.
人们只想着自己。
For their own self.
人们只想着自己，非常的自私，只想自己好。
So instead of being selfish, we want to be selfless.In other words, we want to be willing to sacrifice ourselves for the benefit and for the service of others.
然后灵性的情况刚好是恰恰相反，我们不应该要，我们应该要摆脱这样的自私，变成一个真正无私的人。我们处处想着怎么样让别人好，这就是一个无私的人，他会牺牲自己。然后去成全别人。
Now Lord Chaitanya tells us we should offer all respect to others.
主柴坦亚马哈帕布就说过这样的话，我们应该把所有的尊重、荣耀、献给其他人。
We should not be anxious to get respect, but we should be anxious to give respect to others.
我们应该随时向别人致敬，而不祈求别人对我们尊敬。
But people in the Kali Yuga are not very pious. They're not very religious. They don't have that nature. They're very selfish.
可是这个卡利年代的人的状况，品质真的很低落，就是非常的自私，这个年代的人不虔诚，没有这个真正的宗教心。
When they get some success in their material endeavors, then they're very happy, they're very joyful, and they will tell everyone about it.
在物质存在中，人们呢，哪怕是有那么一点成功，他们就得意，得意洋洋，恨不得全世界都知道。
They will say, "I did it. I made it."I built it.
人们会很得意的说：“你看，我做的，我得到了，你看我了，多么了不起，这些都是我的。”
We're thinking we are the doer, but actually everything is done by Krishna through the modes of nature.
人们洋洋自得的，宣称自己做了什么。可是事实上，我们根本就不是那个作为者，所有的一切其实是在 Krishna 的安排下去完成的，我们根本就没有那个能力可以去做到什么。
So we want to try to overcome this tendency, this conditioning tendency, and in order to overcome this tendency, we have to hear transcendental knowledge.
所以我们应该要去就是抑制自己的这种自私的这种自我的这种倾向。那怎么样才能够摆脱自己的这种倾向呢？那个办法就是我们要聆听超然的知识。
We have to hear about the lives of great devotees and about their qualities and their behavior.
我们要多去聆听这些伟大的奉献者的生活，他们是如何为人处事的，我们要去学习聆听。
We have to become inspired by the lives of the saintly people, and we want to follow their example.
我们必须要从这些伟大的圣人他们的生平事迹典范能够受到鼓舞启发以至于我们自己能够好好的去跟随他们的脚步。
Material energy is very powerful and it bewilders us. We forget our position as a servant and we think of ourselves as the master.
物质的能量真的实在太强大有力了，我们真的常常在物质能量的迷惑下忘了自己其实是那个仆人，我们常常以为自己是主人。
So we have to hear these things again and again because our conditioned nature it goes very deep and it takes a long time to remove that conditioned nature.
所以我们必须一再一再的提醒自己，一再一再的练习，因为我们这种物质的幻觉，物质的倾向实在太根深蒂固了，需要很长的时间的净化，我们才能够就是移除 就是这些根深蒂固的这种物质的概念，物质的心态。
So, conditioned life is like a disease. Just like if we have some disease, and if we've had the disease for a long time,
受制约的生活，真的其实是非常非常的困难的，因为这好比是我们得了病，我们在这场病中必须要纠缠很久，我们必须要想办法快速的赶快把我们这个物质的疾病连根拔除。
Conditioned life, it's a serious disease. When the disease is very serious, then you have to take medicine for a long time to get over the disease.
受制约的生命就像是生了一场重病，生的病得很重，我们真的必须要很有耐心的一直不断的服用药物，才能够帮助我们去除这样的物质疾病。
So the medicine to remove our conditioned nature is simply to engage ourselves in the process of hearing and chanting.
那么我们要服用的是什么药呢？我们必须要服用一帖强力的药，才能够真正的去除我们这种受制约的状态。那么最好的药就是一直不断的聆听和吟诵吟唱 Hare Krishna.
So we have to have faith in this process of bhakti yoga, that this is the real medicine for the disease of conditioned life.
我们一定要对奉爱服务的程序有着坚定的信心，知道它是一帖最有效的药，可以真正的把我们从物质的这种受条件限制、受制约的状况中解救出来。
And we have to want to come to this higher level. We have to want to become a liberated soul.
我们必须要帮助自己上升到高等的层面成为一个真正的解脱的灵魂。
We should not be satisfied to remain in this material condition.
我们千万不要处在这个物质受制约的状态中，我们还洋洋得意的觉得自己在这里的一切都很好，都很满足啊。
We should, therefore, we need to hear regularly about the lives of great devotees, how they dedicate themselves, and how they work in so many difficult conditions.
我们必须要经常的聆听伟大的奉献者的这些事迹。他们是如何就是坚定的就是致力于奉爱服务，无论多少的艰难险阻，他们都不畏惧，还是奋力的摆脱克服所有的一切的困难，继续的做奉爱服务。
We should understand it wasn't easy for people like Prabhupada to go to America and begin the Krishna consciousness movement.
我们要了解释迦牟尼，他只身一人到美国去传扬 Krishna 知觉意识，这绝非一件容易的事情，是多么多么大的，承受着多么大的困难。
Nobody was helping him. Practically, he was alone.
基本上他根本就是一个老人，孤单的去到了美国。
So we may say, well, that was him. I can't do like that. But actually we can. We can all become devotees. We can all become pure devotees if we follow the process.
也许我们会说，不，那是他，那是虚拉帕乌帕，我不是虚拉帕乌帕，我是我，我做不到，我没有办法这样。但是不，我们每个人都应该要有这样的志向，我们应该这样想，我真的想成为一个真正的奉献者，如果我能够遵循这个奉爱的程序的话，我必定也能够成为一个真正的奉献者。
We have to be enthusiastic and eager to follow the process.
我们必须要非常热切地遵循这个程序，必须要非常的热切地想学习各种的东西。
And we have to be patient. It takes time.
而且我们必须要保持着耐心，因为所有的这一切，它都不是瞬间就可以得到，不是一触可及的，它需要耐心的等待，耐心的练习。
Just like devotees came to Taiwan a long time ago, it has taken many years to establish the center in Taipei and Taichung.
就像在台湾也是一样，就是其实也是经历了多年的努力才有现在才有台中中心的成立。
But Krishna has some plan. Now we have a center. Now we to work to try to get people to help in the center to do service.
所以我们了解所有的一切都有 Krishna 的计划现在台中中心终于有了台中中心，那么我们必须要好好的去把握，去珍惜，来想想看怎么能够让人们能够走进来让这个中心可以发展，能够让人们稳定的在中心能够好好的做服务。
We may think, oh, now there's a center, now Krishna consciousness is already there. I don't need to do anything now. I can just sit back. I don't need to go to center.
有的人会这么想反正现在已经有中心了，以为有中心就有了 Krishna 自觉意识的，那就好了。那我现在也不用去忙什么，反正已经有了嘛。那有的人觉得我就是。就是他喜欢就悠闲的在家里就什么事也不用管了，就反正有中心就交给人家去弄就好了。
Just like some people think, oh, now I'm initiated, now I don't need to do anything. I got initiation, so I'm already going back to Godhead.
就像有些奉献者他们启迪了，他一旦启迪了，他觉得说我启迪了，表示我可以回归守神，我有资格，所以他觉得他什么都不用做了，启迪之后反而是倒退了，他就是没有积极的在做些什么服务。
Of course, initiation is only the beginning. We still have a long way to go.
事实不然，启迪其实才是一个开始而已启迪之后应该才是要好好的开始努力的一个时机点，因为还有很长远的路要走。
So in the same way, we think, oh, now we have a center, I'm not needed anymore. There's enough. The work is already done.
那有的人会觉得，反正松信已经有了，一切都落成了，完成了。那我也不用再忙什么了，就这样子，就不太想再参与什么。
Of course, so much to be done. Krishna wants us to work. He doesn't want us to sit back.
这不可能是 Krishna 的意愿 ，Krishna 的计划。他绝对不想看到奉献者们就是懒洋洋的。 就是处在自己的舒适的状态，而不去努力的为中心的发展而做服务这些。
Krishna wants to see how much trouble we're willing to go to in order to be Krishna conscious.
Krishna 喜欢看到奉献者为了要培养 Krishna 知觉意识而付出的就是无论多少的麻烦艰困，他们都牺牲自己而去达成这个任务。
Some people think, oh, too much trouble, I'm going to give up Krishna consciousness. They don't want trouble.
有的人他真的不想要这么麻烦，他说，哦，天哪，原来 Krishna 意识知觉这么辛苦啊，那我不太想，我不要过这种麻烦的生活。
They think everything should be very easy.
他们觉得所有的一切都应该是很轻松很容易。
But actually, it's not so easy.
但是事实上
we need to be willing to accept the difficulty.
但是事实上，所有的一切都不是那么的容易的。我们必须要有自觉、自愿的愿意去付出、去承受这个过程中的种种的磨难、艰辛。
Is always transcendental. He doesn't think something is difficult or something is easy. He sees everything simply as service to Krishna.
Maharaja, you say that devotees are transcendental to everything, and you say what easy, what difficult?
What?
You say devotees are transcendental to everything, right?And then, what do you say? And then?
I said,
devotees are transcendental to difficulty?
If a devotee doesn't consider something to be difficult or something to be easy, he sees everything as service to Krishna.
在奉献者的眼里，所有的一切都是对 Krishna 的服务。无论是轻松，或者是轻松容易，或者是困难，其实对他来说都是一样的，因为重点是为 Krishna 服务，所以奉献者他是超越于物质的存在中的好好坏坏困难或容易，只要是为 Krishna 服务的，他的眼中只有为 Krishna 对 Krishna 的服务。没有所谓的这种比较，这种得失。
And the difficult things, when things are difficult, it gives us more pleasure to serve Krishna.
当事情变得困难的时候，在这个过程中，在服务 Krishna 的时候，竟然所遇到的挫折困难越大。可内心所得到的喜乐也越加的强烈。
The more difficult something is to get, the more we will value it.
事情越加困难的时候，我们就会越加的能够理解这个东西的价值所在。
But if something is very easy, we don't appreciate it. We won't take much care of it.
可是，如果一件事情这么的得来这么容易的话，我们就不会那么的在意，那么的珍惜，那么的重视。
So we have to always check our thinking, check our mind, to see everything in relation to Krishna consciousness.
所以，我们要学习。如何去控制自己的心意，学习怎么能够以一种正确的眼光看待万事万物，总是看到所有的一切跟 Krishna 的关系让自己的心是处在这样的这种超然的视域之中。
And the way to check our mind is by chanting Hare Krishna faithfully every day.
那我们怎么样才能够去控制我们自己的心意，我们的念头思想呢？那就是我们每天应该要好好的念诵 Hare Krishna Mahamantra。
We hear and we're reminded that we're not the body, we're the servant. Krishna is the master, we're the servant. We have to be reminded repeatedly.
我们真的是很健忘的灵魂，我们需要一直不断的每天好好的聆听 Hare Krishna Mantra。如此我们才能够就是提醒自己，永远都不要忘记自己的身份，我们是仆人， Krishna 是主人，我们是仆人我们不是这个身体。
And Krishna is the doer, we're not the doer, we're just the instrument in the service of Krishna.
而且我们才能够借由念诵圣名时时刻刻警醒自己，我们其实根本就不是作为者，我们只不过是 Krishna 的工具我们要去理解我们所做的一切其实只是对 Krishna 的一种服务，并不是好像我做了什么，其实我并不是真正去完成这件事情的人，我只是工具，我只是在为 Krishna 做服务中的一个工具而已。
Sometimes the results are good, sometimes the results are not. But the results are not for us, the results are for Krishna.
而且我们在做任何事情的时候，我们也要去理解怎么样能够去不去执着这个结果，因为有些时候我们会得到好的结果，有些时候结果不尽如人意，但是我们总之要平常心的看待这一切，知道这结果本来就不是属于我的，而是属于 Krishna 的。
So Krishna consciousness teaches us to be detached from the results, but at the same time, we want to work hard and try to get good results.
Krishna 知觉意识教导我们非常重要的一课，就是要不执着的这种精神。虽然我们不执着于活动的结果，但是同时我们应该要好好的努力去获得好的结果，为 Krishna， 为 Krishna 而战。
It's difficult for us becauseWe're thinking, well, I'm not getting the results. It's all going to Krishna. So we think, why should I work hard?
这对我们来说其实也不容易，因为人们都是这样的人们会想，这结果又不是我的，那我干嘛那么认真，那么努力去做什么呢？人就是这样子，所以才说不容易。
But we have to understand that we get the greatest benefit by offering everything to Krishna.
但是我们要了解，当我们以正确的心态、不执着的心态这么去做的时候，去服务 Krishna 的时候，那么事实上我们就能够获得巨大的利益。
To give something to Krishna.Is for our eternal benefit.
当我们把所有的一切献给 Krishna 的时候，我们必将能够得到永恒的利益。
That benefit is going to take us out of the material world and take us back to God.
我们能够得到的利益，最大的利益就是最后我们能够就是摆脱这个物质的可怕的存在，然后回到 Krishna 的身边。
So we have to have faith in the material. We have to have faith in this philosophy.
所以我们要好好的去按照这个教导去做，这样的哲学我们理解了，要好好的去落实。
We have to be eager to go to the spiritual world.
我们必须有这样的渴望，想要到灵性世界。
And we should be very doubtful or pessimistic about the material life.
我们对于自己在物质生存中的这种过的生活，还有所犯的错误，我们必须要就是时时的去质疑自己。
We have to constantly train ourselves to think in this way.
我们必须时时刻刻的帮助自己，训练自己，这么去思维，以正确的方式来过生活。
So Lord Krishna is describing here to Arjuna and to all of us, what is the proper thinking of a devotee?
所以 Krishna 在此在这节诗中，他告诉 Arjuna， 也等于告诉我们什么是一个真正的奉献者，正常的思维。
Okay, are there any questions?
好了，那 Maharaj 问大家讲到这里，不知道有没有什么问题？不管线上还是线下，有没有奉献者有问题？In this verse, in the sloka itself, it says, you know, my very dear devotee never put others into difficulty. Maharaj, you want to elaborate it? Oh, 我忘了翻译出来。我问 Maharaj 说，这节诗中的第一句话就讲到说，我极喜爱的这样的奉献者，他不把别人置于困境。那我请 Maharaj 要不要来讲述一下这句话，来阐述一下。
I'm sorry, Shama, I didn't get everything you said.
Oh, sorry, Maharaj, I say that in the verse,Krishna says, you know, my dear devotee never put others into difficulty. So Maharaj,
yes.
Would you like to say something about this?
Yes, well, yes, this is an important point that in our dealings with other people, we want to be very conscious not to bring trouble onto them, not to put them in any kind of anxiety.
对，这是这一节诗中另外一个非常重要的一件事情，就是奉献者呢，就是要保持着这样的知觉状态，要了解我们不应该把别人让别人陷于困境，给别人带来灾难麻烦。
Yeah, every day we offer obeisances to the devotees and we say we're full of compassion for the fallen conditioned soul.
我们呢每天都会读这个所谓的奉献者顶拜祷文因为奉献者他们是满怀着怜悯之心的就是对堕落的灵魂充满怜悯之心所以我们应该要悲悯拥有这样的奉献者的这种慈悲之心，不把别人置于困境。
A devotee will be very caring and concerned for others. He will go out of his way to try to help others.
奉献者应该要想方设法的 尽自己所能的去关怀照顾其他的人，这是一颗奉献者的心。
We have the example. There was one devotee named Vasudev Datta. He was a great devotee of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
在主彩太阳 Mahaprabhu 的年代，有一位伟大的奉献者，叫做 Vasudev Datta.
Yeah, his name was Vasudev Datta.
他的名字是 Vasudev Datta.
So he came to Lord Chaitanya and he asked Lord, said to Lord Chaitanya, he said, I want to take the sins of all of the people, all the living entities, I want to take their sins and let them all go back to Godhead and I will stay here and suffer for them.
这位伟大的奉献者 Vasudeva Datta, 他来到主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的面前，他真心地向主柴太亚马巴布揭露他的心声，他说，我祈愿所有的众生的罪业都能够来到我身上，我祈求如此他们就能够回到灵性世界，不要继续停留在这个可怕的物质存在中继续受苦。
So when Lord Chaitanya heard this, he was so pleased. And he said to this devotee, he said, you must be Prahlad Maharaj, because this is the mood of Prahlad Maharaj.
当主彩太亚 Mahaprabhu 听到他的这番话，他非常的喜悦。他说，你肯定是 Prahlad Maharaj, 因为Prahlad Maharaj 就有这样的胸怀去悲悯其他的生命。
Yes, Prahlad Maharaj said that he didn't want to just go to the mountains to get liberated himself, but he wanted to go where all the people were to deliver the people.
因为 Prahlad Maharaj他并没有那样的想望，想要自己到深山野地去求取解脱。他不，他真正关心的是这些普通的大众，他们的真实的利益。他非常悲悯这些受条件限制的生命的痛苦。
And there was another great devotee, Ramanujacharya. He was such a nice devotee.His guru gave him a mantra, and his guru told him, if you chant this mantra, you will be liberated.
那还有一位
The guru told him, don't tell people, it's a secret.
那还有一个伟大的奉献者叫做 Ramanujacharya, 那么他的灵性导师给了他一个秘密的 mantra,告诉他说，你只要念诵这个 mantra, 你必定解脱。但是这是一个秘密的 mantra, 你不能告诉其他人。
So, Ramanuja got the mantra, and then he went into the marketplace. And he went in the marketplace and he started yelling out to all the people, chant this mantra and you will be liberated. Chant this mantra.
可是这个 Ramanujacharya 他却就跑到市集在市场中大声的喧嚷，他告诉大家说，请大家来念这个 mantra 吧请大家来赶快来念这个 mantra 吧念这个 mantra 就能够得到解脱。
And the guru came and he said, Hey, I told you this mantra's secret, why are you shouting it out to everyone?
灵性导师就来了，他听到了说，我不是告诉你了吗，不能告诉任何人这个秘密的 mantra, 你怎么在这么多人的群众之中的市场在这边嚷嚷叫大家来念这个 mantra 呢？
And Ramanuja said to the guru, he said, but I want them all to be liberated. You told me this mantra can liberate you. people. So I want them all to be liberated.
可是 Ramanuja 他说，因为你说这个 mantra 可以让人解脱，所以我真正的兴趣是让所有人解脱，所以我想要让所有的人大众都能够知道这个 mantra， 我正想让他们解脱。
He said, I'm not worried about myself. He said, I may get reactions for disobeying your order, but I believe the mantra can liberate people, so I want to give it to everyone.
我也不惧怕，我违背了您的训令会得到什么结果，你看，灵性导师叫他不要跟别人讲，因为是秘密的 mantra。他说我不怕，我不怕违背灵性导师所告诉我的，我宁可把这个 mantra 告诉人们，让人们可以得到解脱。这是我所真正在意的。
So the guru said, the Ramanuja said, oh, you're a better Vaishnava than I am. You're more caring for others than I am.
所以灵性导师说，你是如此的悲悯，你是如此的真正的真心的关怀其他的生命，你比我伟大。You are better than me, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's the true story.
这是真实发生的故事。Okay. Maharaj, there are questions from online devotee from mainland China. The first question is from Radhika Priya Mataji. 由于玛雅的力量非常强大，当人处在嫉妒中时，一般是很难知道自己在嫉妒，所以我们怎么能知道自己是否在嫉妒呢？ OK, Maharaj, you say, since the Maya, do you understand? Do I have to choose? You say Maya?
I want to listen.
OK, so the potency of Maya is very powerful. So whenIn the common people, it's difficult to be conscious. You know, they are envious. When people are envious of others, it's difficult for them to be aware. So how do we know we are in envious situation? We are envious. How do we know we are envious? Because covered by Maya.
Yeah. How do we know?
我们怎么知道呢？
Well, we have to check ourselves. How much are we feeling appreciation and looking up to others, and how much are we looking down on others?
我们还是可以检查自己的。我们可以检查自己。我们多半是在就是在欣赏。就是赞扬着，就看别人的闪光点，还是我们大部分都是在看别人的问题从这里我们可以检视到我们自己是不是处在一种嫉妒的状态，看别人不好还是看别人的好。
When we're envious, then we will minimize any good thing which a person does. We will look down on it. We will not appreciate it.
当我们处在嫉妒中我们就会把别人所做的好的事情把它看轻了就是把它看得很微不足道，就是看轻了，贬低了别人所做的好。
But when we do something, we want it to be considered very great.
而当自己只不过是做了那么一点点事情，就把它很放大，好像自己做了多么了不起的事情。
Yes, so envy is a very subtle thing that often we don't realize that we're envious.
是的，嫉妒是很精细的。 有些时候人们连察觉都没有办法察觉，其实自己是在嫉妒的状态中。
But if we are genuine, we want to really understand, but we have to be willing to admit our own faults. To see wrong in ourselves is not a very easy thing.
那这个来了一个重点，就是说我们能不能坦诚地面对自己的问题、自己的弱点。其实通常人要面对自己都特别的困难啊，就是难以去承认、辨识自己啊的这种问题状态。
We have to be willing to see our faults. Everyone is willing to see.
Maharaj 刚刚有讲到一个我漏掉了这个字眼，就是说他讲到的有这个意愿，人必须要有这个意愿，想要去面对自己的这个问题，想要这个意愿去接受这些问题，看到这些问题。Okay, Maharaj.
Bye.
Anything? Yeah. You want to say anything more in for this question?
Yeah, I wanted to say that chanting Hare Krishna will help us to reflect more on our own position, on our own faults.
Maharaj 最后给我们的这个解药，就是念诵 Hare Krishna 可以帮助我们更深的去反思自己的地位，反思自己的错误、自己的问题。
Yeah, the more we're chanting, then the more Krishna will purify our heart.
我们念诵的越多越好我们就能够越大的得到了 Krishna 的仁慈，让我们的心变得纯净。
We'll be able to see our faults.
我们就越能够去照见自己的问题、自己的错误。
Okay.
好，下一个问题是来自于 Savajaya 曼达吉。顶拜亲爱的 Guru Maharaj 家人们，我的问题是奉献者之间内部合作最重要的是什么？对外合作需要注意什么？ So Maharaj, this question is that offer my obeisance to dear Guru Maharaj and all the family members. My question is that what's the most important thing about devotees cooperation?Means, you know, within our society, you know, what is the most important thing for devotees cooperation? And when we cooperate with outside people, what is the things to be aware? This is actually two questions.
Okay, so the first question.About cooperation.
Yeah, among devotees, cooperation. Among devotees, what is the most thing?
Among devotees.
Yes.
Well, the main thing is we have to be flexible. We cannot always think that I'm right and they're wrong.
奉献者之间的合作有一个很重要的事情，就是人要一直保持在这种自省反省的一种状态中不能永远都觉得我是对的，别人都是错的，我才是对的不能这样子。
So we have to be and we have to respect somebody's authority. Someone may be in the position of authority So they have a right to decide things.
那还有我们要懂得去尊重所谓的权威。因为在社团里面还是有一些领导，他们有权利可以去做一些决策，所以我们要懂得去尊重。
Yeah, so we have to respect someone's authority, that they have the right to decide. We may not agree with them, but we can accept their decision and work with them accordingly.
尽管有些时候我们也许未必能够认同或同意这些处在权威管理者的这种角色的人所做的决定，但是我们还是要保持这个尊重还是要与他合作共同来完成一些事情。
And the second question.
Second question is about when we cooperate with outside people. So what should we be aware of?
When we cooperate with outside people and non-devotees, well, we should be aware that they're not devotees, that they will have their own thinking, that they will have thinking more on the bodily platform.
对外的合作需要注意什么？要注意，既然是对外，就是说我们可能是跟一些非奉献者合作，所以他们很自然，他们的思维方式跟我们不可能是一样的。他们是以躯体的概念来思考的，所以我们先了解对方的思维是什么，我们才有可能跟别人合作嘛。那不然的话，就是沟不通了。Yes.
We have to be tolerant also, you know, that they're not devotees, they don't follow our principles, they don't have our kind of lifestyle. But at the same time, we may need their help in certain things.
当我们要跟外面的人合作，意味着我们可能有些事情必须透过他们来完成。所以他们既然不是奉献者，那么他们很自然的，他们没有遵循我们在遵循的一些规范原则啊，他们过着不是奉献者的生活，但是我们要保持宽容忍耐，要去理解别人的处境，这样子我们才有办法跟别人合作。
And we try to engage them somehow, try to engage them in devotional service.
但是我们还是可以找机会让外面的人可以从事一些奉爱服务。好，谢谢。The next one, Shruti Rupa Mataji, 顶爱亲爱的咕噜和老师们，感恩咕噜用今天这个时节给我很大的鼓励。请问咕噜，当我发现自己除了幸运之外，在灵性知识和技能各方面都非常欠缺的情况下，能不能保持自己的热情，喜欢与人分享的天性，在保持规范的 sadhana 同时，用自己媒体记录自己真实的灵性成长生活与人分享呢？期待咕噜的训示和祝福，感恩。Okay, Maharaj, this is Shruti Rupa Mataji say, you know, thank you, Guru. You know, today's lecture, you choose this verse, really give me so much inspiration. And I would like to know, now I found myself besides very fortunate. I found myself is very fortunate. But except this point, then other aspects, actually, you know, I don't have any skill and also spiritual knowledge. I mean, lack of spiritual knowledge and all kinds of skill. So can I just remain to keep my enthusiasm to share. So, you know, when I keep my sadhana bhakti, and I also take advantage of my media recording to share with others about my spiritual growth. So expecting, looking forward to Guru's instruction and blessing. Thank you.
Yes,
she means,
certainly that's very, very nice that you're sharing your spiritual knowledge with others. Very good.
She says she doesn't have much special knowledge, but she's just fortunate. And so she just prayed that she can keep his enthusiasm to share his spiritual growth. Yeah. Yes.
Yes. Well, she just has to be careful about what she's trying to share with other people.
肯定是可以的。只是当我们在跟别人分享的时候，我们要特别的小心，我们到底分享了什么内容。
You have to bring people gradually to the spiritual platform.
我们必须借由这些分享的东西，能够一步一步、一步一步的帮助人达到这种灵性的水平，这种层面。
So, generally, we want to people to understand that they're spirit soul, that they're not the body.
通常，我们在分享这些灵性的内容中，我们可以借机让人们去理解，我们是灵性的灵魂，而不是这个物质躯体，这种基本的知识。
That one point that can help them overcome many of the problems which are there in condition and material life.
光只是知道了这个基础的知识，就是我们是灵性的灵魂，而不是这个物质躯体，就足以帮助人克服这种受制约的物质生活，去超越这种受制约的状态。
People are not satisfied. They're in so much anxiety. They're afraid. All of these things come about because of thinking we're the body.
仅仅人们因为认同了自己这个躯体，这种躯体化概念，那么人们就一直处在这种不满足，这种焦虑，这种恐惧的状态。
So you're going to give spirit, share your spiritual knowledge with people.
所以我们必须要
try to engage them in spiritual activities.
所以我们必须要去分享这些灵性知识，帮助人们开始在灵性上也能够迈出这一步，开始培养这些灵性的知识。
And if you can introduce them to the chanting of Hare Krishna, then that's a great benefit.
那么如果再有机会，甚至于把 Hare Krishna mantra 介绍给跟你有缘的这些人的话，那么那就是更，那真的是踏出一大步了，能够给人带来很大的利益。
Okay.
Finish? 没有的。Yes, Maharaj, that's all. 没有了 Maharaj, 没有问题了。
No more questions. No more questions,
sir. 对。
Okay, so thank you very much, sir.
谢谢 ,thank you, Maharaj, thank you so much. 你身好 Maharaj,
给
你摘。等一下还有一个问题啊。Okay, Maharaj, this is Shruti Rupa Madaji's comments. He said, okay, thank you, Guru. You know, after your instruction, I will, under your blessing, Bhakrishna
知觉隐藏在一日三餐的灵性素食和尊老爱幼的日常生活来分享，慢慢引导人们对灵性生活的好感和兴趣。谢谢亲爱的 Guru， 孩子非常想念您。 Thank you Guru、After your instruction I will、bear your blessing、in my heart and I will、prepare you know, three meals of prasadam a day、in Krishna consciousness and尊老爱幼的日常生活来分享 and also share all this Krishna consciousness to others、in the mood of respect to the seniors and you know and loving caring、to the junior and gradually guide people、toward spiritual life to help them develop、good feeling andinterest. Thank you, my dear Guru.、my children miss you so much.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Okay.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much, Shama.
Thank you, Maharaj. Nishinha Maharaj ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Bai Zhong Yatra ki
jai. Maharaj, 我们都想念你，很想念你。Maharaj, 赶快来。Hare Krishna.Maharaj, this afternoon we have Harinam. Please give us blessing for the Harinam to give the holy name Prasadam to more people. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Ibo. Hare Krishna. 谢谢 Maharaj.